friends, you guys might know me from the internet as DJ Neo. And today I'm here to talk about the progress that has been made for the upcoming 07 version. And also at the high level to look at some of the differences between 2KHS and the Hockey Games from EA Sports. Especially the latest NHL 20.
Well, before we start, let me introduce myself real quick. Hockey is my lifetime passion. I play hockey in real life since I was a little kid. I had a chance to play for teams like Sparta Prague or Slavia Prague here in the Czech Republic. But that's just history now. Now I'm too old, so I'm stuck with video games, more or less. So, some of you guys maybe think that I'm the biggest 2K guy or whatever, but it's a little more complicated than that. My very first hockey, and by the way, what you now see on screen is me randomly tuning the game during the years. Anyway, my first hockey video game was a hockey game made for a computer called Amiga 500. It was called Face Off, I believe, and another good hockey game from that period was Wayne Gretzky Hockey, sometimes around 1991 or 1992. Then when NHL 94 came on PC, I became maybe the biggest EA Hockey fan. I bought and played literally every NHL game from EA Sports on PC, right until the NHL 07 in 2006, when I bought Xbox just so I can continue to play the most advanced hockey video game, which I believed was from EA Sports, of course. And it was actually the very first year when I realized another company makes hockey video games. So yeah. So I bought both these games, NHL 07 and NHL 2K7, and I be honest, I played 07 most of the year. Skill Stick was introduced and it was just great. It was a revolution. I think EA deserves a lot of credit for the offensive skill stick. It was very innovative that time and I'm really happy they came up with it. Unfortunately, that was actually the last truly innovative thing or feature that EA bring to their hockey video games. It might sound a little weird because of its almost 10 years of additional development, but if you put the old NHL 09 next to the latest NHL 20, the AI of these games plays almost identical. Yeah, it does look better graphically, but the actual AI follows the same up and down primitive routines using the same robotic, laser-fast passing system like in the early 90s. So, the problem I have now as an adult with EA's version of hockey is that there is no real physics in EA's hockey. It feels to me like there is just a bunch of scripted events and outcomes for very limited number of pre-programmed situations that EA developers put into their game years ago, and these few events, so to speak, are repeated over and over again, where in 2K Hockey the gameplay is driven organically by the physics. Yeah. The physics might have holes, it might be buggy at times, but it still feels much more like a real hockey, where EA's approach feels like a shallow video game for 10-year-old kids. By any means, I'm not saying 2K Hockey is flawless. It's not. 2K Hockey has many holes in AI as well, especially on the defensive side of the puck. But you kinda feel like it makes sense because the gameplay is so organic. Every game, every shift feels different and AI has to react dynamically on what's going on the ice. So you just kinda understand that it's, you know, hard to program the AI like this. It's understandable. And you feel it's worth. You appreciate it. Because when you have procedurally generated gameplay like this with a dynamic real-time presentation, which is a very important part of the package, you get immersed. You get sucked into the game, you feel like you're playing the actual game of hockey, where on the other hand, with more polished NHL 20 or 19 or 18 or 17 and so on, you feel like your experience is always limited by these few scripts and you get bored. Some of you guys maybe know I was this so-called game changer around 2016-17. But I just gave up. I was in the EA studios in Vancouver several times and we even had the direct communication channel set up with the developers where we used to chat about the game and comment some prototypes. So it was pretty awesome experience for me, you know, for a guy, for a fan of this series from the early 90s. But on the other hand, it was disappointing. When I finally realized that with the direction that Sean or MJ Singh chose for this franchise, for EA Hockey, I actually can do much more if I'm not part of this prominent group of chosen ones. I can do much more for our simulation crowd if I leave, if I go away and talk about it loud and from outside. So the point is, and I'm reading this from you guys quite often, I'm not working on the 2KHS to bring EA a competition. That fact alone would not justify at all the crazy amount of time I had to dedicate to this project. The main reason is that the 2K Hockey is different, and it's different in a good way. Even with all the flaws, it is still a better representation of hockey. It's much closer to the real thing, if that is what you are looking for, of course. Now, in the following weeks, I'll do my best to explain what I was able to do with the latest 2K attempt at hockey, which was the NHL 2K11 from 2010, I think, yeah. Well, I'm sure I won't be able to cover absolutely everything that I was able to change or improve through the years. Just to name a few, a lot of the goalies' animations are fixed. The skating was basically broken down to pieces and then rebuilt from scratch again. Another thing I'm really proud of is the new dynamic acceleration system. And I'm really can't wait to show you how it looked before and how it looks now and how much such a thing alone can completely change the flow of the game. The puck physics is different, and when I say different, it's not just that something is slower or faster. The shots or dumping or passing now feels very different thanks to the improved puck trajectory, for example. Also, I was able to separate how the players react on the ice friction with and without the puck. So now players without the puck are more agile than a player that is in a position of the puck, just like in the real life. Next huge thing is that I was able to find the code addresses for the offensive and defensive stick. So, for example, no longer a player can deny the loss of physics and skating basically in full speed while sweeping the defensive stick or using the offensive skill stick. Also, the player direction now respects the direction of skates and plates. All shooting animations are fixed. I was successful in locating the AI code for shooting, so I can now tune what kind of shots, from what place on the ice, and how often the AI player will shoot the puck. Well, we haven't even started talking about the visual improvements. I don't wanna go into more details now, because I see I'm awfully long with this introduction already. So I think I will end this video by saying this. In the following videos, you will probably be hearing me say a lot. I fix this, I fix that. I would really like to say loud and clear that I have a great respect for the original developers at the Visual Concepts that have worked on this game. At the end of the day, they had their tasks from their bosses. They had to follow their visions of fun and simply haven't such a luxury of freedom as I have alone, so I believe I do believe if these guys had few more years to develop this game and probably a little more luck in people that was in charge of this game, then this game could easily be on the same level as the award-winning NBA 2K brother, which by the way is running on the same engine as is running the NHL 2K9, 2K10, 2K11 and of course 2KHS aka 2K Hockey Simulator. So that's why we are here today, right? To continue in what they have started. Stay tuned.